what we're going to try and do today is we are going to have a go at making a deep sea submarine, but in a bottle. So here's one in true Blue Peter style that I made earlier. So you can see up the top there, there is my awesome submarine. So this is called a Cartesian Diver after René Descartes, who was a famous French scientist. But the cool thing about the submarine is, like a proper submarine, you can make it go up and down. Look at that! And because clearly I have Jedi powers, I'm using the Force to do that. I'm going to make it just hover halfway there. And I really love, if anyone here has got little brothers or sisters and you want to freak them out and make them think that you do actually have Jedi powers, or that you are one with the Force, or maybe you're Matilda, then this is a really good trick. How I'm making it sink is by squeezing the bottle, okay? So have a think about how squeezing the bottle might make that work. And then maybe as we're making one, you'll be like, I totally get it now. I totally get the science. So what you need is a large 2 liter plastic bottle, and you need to fill it right to the brim. You can't have, try and have as small airspace as possible to fill it right to the brim with water. And then what you do is you get a pen lid, and some pen lids don't go all the way through. This one does. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some blue tack. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the hole at the top, so that way I can trap air up inside, and that obviously is what makes it float. Then I need to make it a little bit heavier, so I'm going to get a little bit more blue tack, and I'm going to roll that into a sausage, and I'm going to wrap that around the bottom of my submarine. Now this takes a little bit of trial and error, and it depends on how big your bottle is, depends on how big your pen lid is, but what you're aiming for is something like that, and you want it to just float. There we go, so that is just floating, that's how you want it. So what I've got an air bubble trapped inside the lid with a heavy thing at the bottom to hold it down and give it a little bit more weight. So what's happening then, how this is working, is as I squeeze the bottle, I'm increasing the water pressure inside the bottle. And all those water molecules, they're like, oh, I'm being forced against the other water molecules. And they want to go somewhere, but they haven't got anywhere to go. So when I squeeze the bottle, the water molecules are then squishing the air bubble. They're forcing the air bubble smaller, and because the particles in air are much further apart, they can be squashed. So then it stops being buoyant, it doesn't have as much upward force anymore, and then gravity, or the weight of the paperclip and the blue tack, ends up winning, and it sinks to the bottom. What I'd like people to do is, if you have made any brilliant divers, film yourself making one and send it in to us. That would be brilliant. Thank you very much. You can get reverse Cartesian divers that sit at the bottom, and you squeeze the bottle and they come up.